What's up, YouTube? So today is July 20th, 2015. As you guys can see, once again, I am in the middle of nowhere. I'm walking on the road. There are no houses around here. It is sketchy as hell. But yeah, this is what I do. So the plan for today is to hit this place called the Frankford Creek, which is in Port Richmond, Pennsylvania. This place is an industrial zone. There are no residences, okay? So the place can get sketchy really, really fast. I'm telling you guys this because, you know, I wouldn't advise anyone to come here alone to fish, okay? If you decide one day to come fishing here, please do not bring your kids. If you bring your kids, make sure you have a group of 2-3 people. Like I said, this place can get sketchy really, really quick. But anyways, regardless of socio-economical conditions, the Frankford Creek is a tidal body of water, a tributary of the Delaware River. And over the years, I've had very good success in this place, fishing for common carp, channel catfish, you know, all the other species that belong to the Delaware River. So I will keep you guys updated. I still got about a 5-10 minute walk to the fishing spot, and hopefully we will be able to land some carp. You know, I got my two rods here with me. I got my carp net, my Bowser Metallica. This is my trusted net for big fish, man. And I got my corn in my bag. It is well known in the fishing community that a couple 30 pounders came from the spot in terms of carp. Now, I didn't prepare them. I didn't do any prior preparations. So, you know, I'm fishing on the spot. Hopefully, I'll be able to catch some fish. Hopefully, I will have something to show you guys. Let's just put it that way. I'll keep you guys updated. Okay, I am finally arriving at my fishing spot. There are two bridges over here. Not sure if you guys can see it or not. There's one railroad bridge, and then there's another bridge behind this railroad. This railroad bridge is for the Atlantic City Speed Line run by the New Jersey Transit. And the one behind that one is the Betsy Ross Bridge in Northeast Philadelphia. The spot that we will be fishing is right next to this electrical company. Now, this electrical company, of course, is no trespassing, but the place we're going to be fishing at is absolutely fine. It's right next to it. So once I get there, I'm gonna give you guys a good view of the place. All right, so we are finally here. There seems to be nobody here, although we do have a lot of trash and a shady cooler right over here. I am a little bit scared of opening this cooler, but I'm gonna do it anyways. Okay, there is nothing inside this cooler, but there is one shady ass cooler right here. Anyways, okay, so this, folks, is the tidal Frankford Creek, and right now is like dead low tide. It's going towards low tide. I'm gonna set up my stuff here real quick, and I'm gonna be back once my setup is ready. But this is the place where we will be carping, all right? And hopefully we will be able to land some good carp today. Please notice that it's extremely hot today. It is about 90 degrees, and that's why, you know, I had a good idea that this place wouldn't be taken, like nobody would be fishing here. I mean, you're gonna be extremely crazy to fish out here with this sun at a temperature like this. And right now we are talking like 1 p.m. All right, let me set up my stuff here and I'll be back. All right, folks, I'm just finishing my first setup here. So let me show you what I'm using. Today I'm going to be using my Daiwa Samurai Heavy Action Combo with 50 pounds Power Pro braided line. I'm using a 1-ounce egg sinker with a mustad snap swivel and a snailed size 6 eagle claw hook. All right, and look, what I'm going to do is for bait, for the common carp, it's very easy. You just get the kernel corn, you see? I don't know if you guys can see it or not. I will show you soon if not. Here, I just put 2 pieces of kernel corn on my hook, all right, which the tip exposed. This is how I like to do it. Now, if you guys are into the trends of common carp fishing, you guys know that they have the hair rigs, the bolt rigs, and all that stuff. Casually, I will use a hair rig, but this is my way to go, is lip sinker setup, okay? I'm not gonna cast too far away. Right, there we go, perfect. That's where I want it to be. Okay, there we go. Now, one thing that is fundamental for carp fishing, okay, and when I say fundamental, I do mean it, you have to chum. Okay, so this is what we do. You memorize where you have casted your stuff, and you throw corn right around it. All right, look, this is what I'm doing. I'm chumming right now. I'm throwing pieces of corn right around where I cast my stuff. This is the art of chumming. My second rod is going to be right here. So I'm just gonna chum right now. Not too far away, right? And you have to be careful. You have to take into account the current, the velocity of the water, because before your corn falls all the way down, it's gonna get dragged a little bit by the current, right? That's why I'm casting more towards this way, so it can fall right over there where I want it to. Once the chum is done, you are pretty much good to go. All you need to do is wait. Make sure you set your drag loose. In other words, you know, don't let your drag be closed, all right? Carp, man, they will give you a good run for it. If we are talking about like a big carp, we are talking even about a better run. So make sure you have your drag set correctly. I gotta set up my second rod now. I'll be back once everything's done. All right, folks, I got my second setup all good to go. I just need to punch a little kernel corn on. 2 kernel corns with the hook exposed for my second setup. I'm using my Cortland Endurance 9-foot rod with my Shimano Symmetry 4000 FL. 12 pounds Berkeley Vanish fluorocarbon with the same setup as the other rod. Slip sinker, mustad, snap swivel, size 6 snell hook, and 2 pieces of corn. I'm gonna cast. There we go, that's where I want it to be. All right, perfect. See, I'm just gonna leave it here, and then I'm all set. Now I just need to wait for the bite. Now, I don't know if you guys can notice or not, all the junk in the creek is floating this way, okay? And that means that this is an incoming tide. The tide is no longer getting out, it's actually coming in. And this is good for me because the Frankford Creek, as I know it, as I mentioned before, is a tributary of the Delaware River. Once the tide comes in, all the huge fish from the Delaware on the mouth of the Frankford Creek, they start to come in and look for food. So that's good, okay? I mean, I picked this specific spot because I know that this area right here that I've chummed is one place where they usually stop at to look for food, all right? It's like a route for carp. Every day, a school of carp passes here this way, and all outcoming tide, they go that way. All right, so now we just gotta wait for the bites, see if anything hits. Hopefully, I'll be able to land a carp. Meanwhile, I'm gonna start opening my net. You know what they say, right? It's better to be safe than sorry. So I'm gonna open my net, make sure everything's all right. Hopefully, I'll have some carp to show you guys. Whoa, we got a bite here. Folks, we got a bite. Whoa, all right. First carp of the day, I think. Yeah, nice, nice run, nice run. Yeah, it's a carp, all right, it's a carp. First run of the day. Gotta make sure the fish doesn't go too much to the left. Whoa, it's a strong one. Okay. There we go. I can tighten the drag a little bit more now. I gotta let it run for now, but it's heavy, folks. It's heavy. It's running to the left side of the creek. First carp of the day. Oh yeah. Oh boy. You see that bend on that rod? Yeah. Gotta wait until they run and tire themselves, you know? Can't force it. Wow, this is a nice carp. All right, finally. It's time to pump it little by little. Whoa, smart. It run all the way to the bridge, to the pillar of the bridge. I can't let it run to the other side or I'm gonna lose this fish. So, slow, nice and easy. Yeah, it's a nice carp. First run of the day within 5 minutes that I'm here. So far, looks like it's going to be a good day. I got some trash on my line too. It's making it a little bit difficult to reel this fish in, but no worries there. Okay, it's finally coming. All right. Come on, carp. Yeah. Yes, it's running to the right side now. Make sure it doesn't touch my other line. It's right in front of me now, folks. It's right in front of me. Here. Yes, it's a nice one. I saw it. Not a monster, but it's a nice one. It's a nice one, folks. It's a nice one. Net ready on one hand, fishing rod on the other. Yeah. I'm gonna bring this fish up. It's a nice one. Nice one. And now just gonna be careful here. Okay, net's in the water. Oh, muddy hell. Yeah! First carp of the day, fellas. I'm on top of the mud. Yes. And our fish is on. Baby, hell yeah. Wow. This is a nice fish right here, folks. First one of the day. Nice common carp right here. I'm gonna bring it up a little bit. I'm not gonna take it out of the net because I don't want it to hurt itself. But you guys can take a nice view. Not trophy, but a nice carp right here. All right, let's do a quick job in weighting this guy and releasing this fish. Whew. I'm gonna take this trash out of stuff here. First carp of the day. All right. Okay, let's unhook this guy. Pliers. Okay. Carp is unhooked. Take a photo of it. Quick photo. Quick release. Quick weight in. All right. First carp of the day, fellas. There we go. Yes, I have a nice view of it. I'm still shaking from the adrenaline. Right. Two photos. Gotta do a quick measurement and quick release. Okay, let's see. Okay. Let's measure it. I measure it on the net so I don't hurt the fish. It says here almost 15 pounds. 14. Okay. Yeah, I'll take it 15 pounds. 15 pounds minus 1.5 from my net. That makes 13.5. First one of the day. All right. All right, folks, I just rebaited my rod. Same setup, two pieces of kernel corn, and I'm gonna cast at the same spot. You know, that's usually how it goes with the carp fishing. So there we go, not too far away, same spot. All right, gonna leave it my rod over here. And this is the deal, every time I catch a fish, meaning, you know, I know that a fish touched the chum, I get some more corn, and I chum the exact same place where the fish bit. All right, just a little bit, not a lot. For summertime, this is kind of enough. All right, so we got ourselves one carp already. Let's see if we can catch more. Oh, whoa, whoa, we got ourselves a bite. But this does not look like a carp. So let's see what we got here. And let's see if the fish is on. Fish on. I think this is a catfish. I think this is a little catfish. Yeah, it's a catfish. You know, folks, sometimes when you fish for carp, catfish will eat your chum too, of course. I mean, a lot of different types of fish like kernel corn. So there we go, our culprit, a channel catfish. Let me bring this guy up here. He's not really big. I'm just gonna pull it by the line. Well, turns out he's a little bit bigger than I expected, but that's absolutely fine. Okay, got ourselves here a channel catfish on the kernel corn. I'm not even gonna measure this guy. I would say, whoa. Oh, aggressive, huh? Aren't you? But anyways, I'm not even gonna measure this guy. I just gotta assume this guy is two pounds. That's it. Let me take this hook out of him. There we go. All right, fellas, quick update. So I'm fishing the Frankford Creek here in Port Richmond. As I've mentioned previously, right over there, that bridge over there is the Betsy Ross Bridge. I'm right here at the tidal Frankford Creek, and the mouth of the Delaware River is right over there. Okay, so I've been fishing here for 45 minutes now. I caught a 13.5 pounds common carp, and I caught one channel catfish. That's it so far. And you know, I just wanted to tell you folks, anyone who wants to go out there to do some carp fishing, as you guys saw it is very, very simple. But on the same hand, like at the same time, one needs to be very patient with it, okay? So, you know, I would describe the process one more time. You come to a spot that you think the carp feed at. That's the first spot. So you pick a body of water, you pick somewhere that you think there are common carp around, and you just set up your stuff there. Second thing that you need to do, you need to chum the water, okay? No chum, no carp. You may get a carp once in a while if you get lucky, you know, that they just happen to be feeding around. But the purpose of chumming is to create a feeding frenzy, all right? It's a huge misconception in the fishing community that carp are dumb fish. There is no such thing as dumb fish. Carp are actually very smart. They have very good instincts, okay? So if they see two pieces of kernel corn just lying somewhere, you know, they're not going to eat it, okay? They are smarter than that. But if you chum a place and then you place your corn among your chum, that's when the magic happens, okay? The carp starts to feed on the chum and the carp starts to think, you know, oh, so it is okay to eat this corn. It's perfectly safe. So it's kind of, you kind of put its guard down, let's say this way. And then once it gets your hook, it is too late. That's the time, you know, that you hook the carp. One extra additional piece of information for carp fishing, please refrain from using big hooks, okay? It is not that you can't catch them on big hooks, but you should use smaller hooks. I don't know if you guys saw it or not. I mean, you can Google it, but the mouth of a carp is actually very, very small, okay? I'm using size 6 Eagle Claw hook because I want to avoid the smaller species of fish like white perch and some small channel catfish. Otherwise, I would be using like a size 8 hook. That's like my ideal size hook for common carp. That's just how I like to do things. So again, you know, it doesn't matter which part of the world you are at, where you are, right? You want to do some carp fishing, get your rods, make sure you set your drag correctly, chum, and just wait. And even if you don't catch anything during that fishing session, right, come back the next day to the same spot where you chummed and chum again. You know, some carp anglers, I would say a good percentage of USA carp anglers, they do this thing called pre-chumming. You know, even before the day of the session, they just go to places and they just chum the water. They're kind of preparing the spot for the day when they're going to fish there. Alright, anyways, 45 minutes down, I'm gonna stay here for a good while, hopefully something else is gonna bite, hopefully I will be able to land some more carp, I'll keep you guys updated. Whoa, alright, we got a bite here. Yes, sir. Now, I don't know if this is a carp or not. Fish on. No, it doesn't look like a carp. Looks like a catfish. Yeah, looks like a catfish. But I'll take it. Alright, whoa. Okay. Swimming nicely. That's the second catfish of the day. Just gonna make sure the fish is out of my chum. That's all. I don't want it circling around my chum so it spooks all my carp, you know? Alright, little nice catfish. Second one of the day. Alright. So we got ourselves a second catfish of the day. Let me leave it over here so this beast doesn't splash all over. There we go. All right, little nice catfish. Let me unhook it real quick. Very, very active, guys. They are eating all my corn down there. All right, unhooked it nicely. All right. Let me take a photo, quick release. Frankford Creek, channel catfish. There we go. Second catfish of the day, second channel catfish of the day, all right? But we are in pursuit of common carp, so bye-bye, fella. There he goes, happily. All right, now we're gonna hope for the carp. Whoa! All right, is this fish on? Let's see. Oh yeah, it's on. Fish on, but it doesn't feel like a carp again. Oh, it's a catfish. Get out of my chum, catfish. Oh, he got off. But it's all right though. It was a small channel catch. About a pounder or so. So you know, we didn't miss much. All right, so far one common carp, two channel catfish, and hopefully we will land some more. All right, folks, quick update. I've been fishing for 2.5 hours, almost 3 hours now, and the bite is low down a lot. So, you know, it's like 92 degrees out today, super, super hot. And you know, I don't want to risk the chances of getting a heat stroke. So I'm just going to start packing up right now. Final count for the day, one common carp at 13.5 pounds and two channel catfish. That's it, you know, I'm happy today already that I was able to land some fish here at the Frankford Creek. Again, very, very hot day, all right? Whew! I'm dehydrated right now. I'm pretty sure I'm suffering from, you know, the initial symptoms of a heat stroke. So as soon as I get home, I already know what I gotta do. I'm just gonna relax, drink a lot of water, and so on. I'm gonna start packing up, and hopefully next time I come, you know, I'll be able to land some more carp for you guys to see.